In this video, we're going to expand brackets where we have an algebraic term on front of the bracket. And remember in the previous video, we saw that to expand brackets means to get rid of the brackets, and we do the term on front of the bracket multiplied by each term inside the bracket. So let's do this first one. We'll copy it out. We do the term on front of the bracket, which is the x, multiplied by each thing inside the bracket. So the x times the 2x, the x times the y, and the x times the 3, like that. So let's do the x times the 2x first. Well, x multiplied by x is x squared, because, for example, 3 squared means 3 times 3, doesn't it? So x squared means x times x. So we write that as x squared, but we've also got that 2 there, so it's 2x squared. Next, we've got x times by y, which will just be xy. Remember, in algebra, if we had xy, the letters are next to each other, so it just means you multiply them together, x times by y. And we try to avoid the time symbol in algebra. Finally, we've got x times by 3, which is 3x. Remember, we say 3x with the number on the front, not x3. We have 3 lots of x, we don't say x lots of 3. So that's the final answer. What about the second one? Well, we do the term in front of the bracket times by each thing inside, so the 3m times the 6, the 3m times the minus m, and the 3m times the 2n. Now, the 3m multiplied by 6, 3 times 6 is 18, so it's 18m. The 3m times by the minus m, well, the m times m is m squared, and because it's positive times negative, it's going to be negative, and you've got this 3 here, so that's going to be minus 3m squared. And finally, we've got the 3m times by the 2n. Now, the m times the n is just mn, and then we've got the 3 times the 2, which is 6, so it's going to be plus 6mn, and that is the final answer.